You ain't gotta argue with these motherfuckers that don't know what they talking about. It's hard. Like, you ain't got to. Like, you ain't got to.
Hard.
Like, you can just.
Yeah.
Oh, about to go fuck. Bro, about to go crazy.
Brother.
What's going on? It's Quent Jonny.
It's your boy Jonny P.
And this is First Listen. So, Drake finally dropped 2 a.m.
Big night. It ain't quite 2.
Yeah.
123, you know, 123, made his way a little bit, you know, part of the marketing. That's part of the marketing.
Got it.
So, yeah, we got the certified lover boy. Let's see. Niggas been waiting 9 months.
Mm-hmm.
So, is it going to be worth the wait?
This is a fact. Do you got any expectations? Any, what you feeling? You think, put it like this. Do you think he's going to overtake Kanye? Kanye just dropped last week.
I heard this album. I forgot who said it. Academics or somebody, but
I ain't trusting that one.
Well, I heard this album. He's gonna be rapping on this shit and not as much singing, despite what the title said. So,
all right, shit. It's
that's what I heard. That's my only preconceived notion.
All right, so we on the intro. The intro, champagne poetry. Let's get it. He started off with a fucking shot. Good God.
What he said?
Fuck evaluation, show me personal funds. That's a shot straight at Kanye. You started off with a shot. Because, you know, Yeezy was evaluated at it. But he's saying, nigga.
Fuck that, show personal funds.
Nigga. Golly. Okay.
Like I say,
we know what time it is,
bro. That sound like some rapping.
Yeah, we know what time it is, bro. All right, bro.
It's sold out already, got a whole new set of toys. Shit is so surreal, Drizzy Drake, you better enjoy. Nothing else bigger than the OBO Letterman boys. Catch me a next for the nighttime boat rides. Ollie got the first edition, part of roadside. The only sign of struggling is coming from those guys. I'm trying to just relate what I can see through my own eyes. And nothing tell the truth like the eyes will. Live so much for others, don't remember how I feel. Friends in high places and friends that are high still. Still manage to move, walk straight through a minefield.
I see where you at, Drake. I see where you going with it.
That's him in his bag, shit.
I see you, bro.
Brother sat right back and read the room.
Alright.
And above me, I see nobody. I'd have to be dead for them to say that you took it from me. The 20% of you that we own is my tootsie's money. Nigga, I'm wild and put your bread, you owe it to me. CJ grab racks out of the bag and throw it to me. They don't want a problem with the boy, but it's going to be. Trust in my brothers as strong as I know it should be. Future signing contracts, he don't even show it to me. I don't have to second guess nothing with no one I love. About to build a second guess house, we'll be growing too much. Think I gotta...
Nah, but I'ma still want to see that contract. I don't think I'm putting that much trust in my man. I still want to at least take a little peek at it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, he's saying that, but then, like, not probably the biggest contract he's looking at that day. Like, in his future. You know, it's probably not like, you know.
I get it. It's probably just the future.
It's probably not the biggest.
Like, to him.
To
like,
us. Yeah, yeah.
That shit probably like $500,000.
Yeah, okay,
but that equates to $50 to us.
Whatever, yeah, whatever.
Yeah,
go ahead and
you got it.
Yeah, you got it, bro. That's the crazy part.
Yeah. Now, that's valid. That's a valid point.
Love back is
what
you mean to me? Until I do, I'm hoping you
Bro about to go crazy.
Bro, the transition on that shit was ridiculous, bro.
Yeah. It was the kick drum and the let me know.
And then he just switched the sample. That shit wild.
Yeah, now this is gonna be different. Alright.
We ain't even 2 minutes in, 2.5 minutes in.
The city's on fire and people are in denial. Charges being labeled, we'll see what they do at trial. I'm calling the shit from now. Sweetheart deals that the judge has been handed down. I haven't been able to see family for a while. That shit is wearing me out. I used to hide my pain in the lala behind the bar till my niggas carried me out. And if money's all I need in my grave, then bury me now. I know I tend to talk about how I got a fortune on me, but with that comes the politics the city been forcing on me. Man, I can't even RIP and show my remorse to the homie. No, I carry the guilt of the city's misfortunes on me. I even got the cleanest staff plotting extortion on me. My parents' divorces on me. My therapist's voice is making the choices for me. And I always say to myself, cause no matter what they reporting on me, the pressure is weighing up.
Said my therapist's voice is making the choices for me.
And that's...
Black people, get your mental health checked out, man. Like, real talk. That's one of the biggest issues in this country. Mental health matters, bro.
Even though it sounds like, I don't know. That was an interesting perspective to put on it. Because to an extent, it sounds like he almost feels as though he's a puppet to what is...
the therapy?
To what the therapist is saying. He's saying he's making the choices for me. Where...
That's not necessarily a bad thing if you got a good therapist. No, and if you got a therapist that helps you put stuff in perspective.
Gotcha.
That's all a therapist is. They ain't gonna give you no answers. So. Yeah. They ain't gonna tell you what to do, but they just put shit in perspective for you. Mm-hmm. And that's a lot of what mental health is, though. Just understand that you ain't the only one going through it. It ain't just you.
Yeah.
It ain't just, it feels like it because you're you, and everybody experiences this thing called life differently, but, in reality, it's a billion of us out here, so it's always somebody to lean on for no matter what situation you're going through.
Right.
So that's,
Valid.
Career's going great, but now the rest of me's fading slowly. My soulmate somewhere out in the world just waiting on me. My chef got a recipe for disaster, baking slowly. My heart feels vacant and lonely, but still, I'm making the most of this shit and more. Every single move is like rolling dice on the board. See too many brothers get 25 from the boys. I'd rather see all of them get 25 from the Lord. And if the last negotiation made you pay me 25, well, this is the perfect time to give me 25 more. I'm bigger now than before. Co-parent of the year, we figured out a rapport. No fair with Drizzy, made on the second leg of the tour. How can anybody tell you the truth when they misinformed? How the niggas turning up when you turn you into rewards?
Listen, that shit just takes me to fucking arguing with the new super woke niggas, bro. I ain't gonna lie. And not understanding that half of their arguments is based off clickbait headlines. And it's like, how can I argue with you when you ignore the fact that you don't understand that what you're saying is based off of not real shit at all?
You gotta do the research. If you don't do the research, you can't even talk to it.
But people don't know that. And that's the point he's making. Like, a lot of people think they have the information. But,
I mean, really,
it's all surface.
I don't know, man. But it's like, you ain't got to argue with these motherfuckers that don't know what they talking about.
It's
like,
hard.
You ain't got to. Like, you can just, if at the job or something, if you say something to me that, like, displays your ignorance, conversation over.
But my thing is that
it's like, why am I
by nature I'm a teacher. So I always wanna kinda get people to understand.
I get that.
You know what I'm saying?
I get the importance in that.
When I see like the ignorance peeking out or like, oh, there's a fallacy in how you thinking.
I know for one thing, I'm not a teacher. Like both my parents were educators, I ain't got patience, I'll show you through example.
This nigga didn't read well.
You know, yeah, both of my parents are educators. Yeah, so, yeah. But and I'm not. I am not. Mm-hmm. I ain't got that kind of patience. Like mm-hmm. I'll tell you once. You know, if you ain't gonna people don't listen. So like, and I ain't.
That's also true.
Repeating myself too many times to stupid people, but it's neither here nor there.
Valid. All right.
We managed to win everything what it was. Windows of opportunity, let me go through the doors. This the part why I don't ever say part of me anymore. This the part why I'ma find a new part of me to explore. This the part why my partners know what we in it for. This the part where we gon' throw us a party after the war. And if the last negotiation had you feeling out of pocket, well this is the perfect time that I empty their shits for sure. You owe that shit to the boy. Yeah.
Sets the tone for what niggas been, you know, he said a lot of shit that, you know, niggas been kind of anticipating. Mm-hmm. You know, it's been a while since we heard from, you know, the lover boy, so we want to see where his head's at.
But, certified co-parent of the year.
It sounded like he out for blood, though.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, it sounded like
I thought he was going to talk a little more slicker on the second half of it. With that beat change, I think that first part was, like, very memorable. The second part was kind of like, well, I mean, the second part was good. Don't get me wrong. It's like judging Drake by Drake's
standards. But I think that time he was just wanting to get some shit off.
Yeah.
You know, he just probably had some shit. You know, intro was just for getting shit off your chest.
Valid.
And you can come in and flex for the rest of the album. But
valid. No, I like it. I like it. Like you said, it set the tone. I fuck with it. All right. What's that? Champagne Poetry. Valid.